Now, in this video, we're going to learn how to save an MP3 using Audacity. Now, Audacity doesn't allow you to export or save files as MP3s just as it is when you download it. And there's some legal issues around that, where Audacity, the creators of Audacity, don't own the MP3 rights. So you have to actually do a little bit of changes to Audacity in order to make it work. We're going to go through those changes today. Now, if you notice here, I've got the internet started. And the reason I've got that done is because we need to download a new file to go along with Audacity. And that file is called the Lame Encoder. Okay, the Lame Encoder. Now, here's what we got to do to find that one. We're going to go into Google, and we're going to do a search for Audacity. And just as when you download Audacity the first time, you'll notice that it says Audacity Free Audio Editor and Recorder. That's the place we want to go. So we'll click on that one. And it takes us to the Audacity website. So what we'll do is we'll go ahead and we'll click on Download Audacity 1.2.6, and that'll take us to the download page. Now, here's where we need to find the Lame Encoder. And look at this. Lame MP3 Encoder allows Audacity to export MP3 files. You see that? That's what we need to click on. So we'll click on that one. And the next thing we want to go to, you can read all this if you like. We need to go to the Lame download page. We click that link. I'm sorry for so many clicks in this tutorial, but it's well worth it. Now we're at a place where we can find many different places to download the Lame encoder. I'm just going to pick the second one from the top, but you can pick whichever one you like depending on where you live. Now we're given, do we want to save the file? And yes, we want to save that file to the disk. So I'll just click Save and OK, and it's downloaded. So now the next thing we need to do is to open that file. Now before we open the file, I'm going to get you to open another folder first. And the folder is the place where we need to place all of our new files. Okay, now first thing I'm going to get you to do is open My Computer. As I have open here now. Yours may look a little different, of course, but you want to then find the C drive. Okay, so double click on the C drive. And as you can see, I have a D and an F and a whole bunch of other ones, but you want to open the C. So double click on C. And then the next thing you want to find a folder called Program Files. That's Program Files. And there might be quite a few file folders here, but you need to go down until you find Program Files and double click on that one. And the last folder we need is Audacity. You can see it here. Mine's near the top. It's in alphabetical order, so it's generally near the top. Yours may look a little different, but double-click on the Audacity folder. Now, let's leave that folder open. Now, the next thing is you downloaded a file, the lame and some numbers .zip. So I'm not sure where you downloaded. You may have downloaded it on the desktop. You may have downloaded it to a specific folder. But I download mine right here. So now what I want you to do now is double click on that lame file, that lame.zip file. And now we're given a number of files, and in order to what we want to do is to move those files over into the Audacity folder that you can see on my left. So you can move them over one at a time if you like, or if you want to, you can hold your mouse button down and slide your mouse and slide it over all of the files until they all turn blue. Now I'll show you how I did that again. I moved down to the bottom right and I held my mouse button down and I slid it up over with my mouse held until I got all the icons turned blue, and then I let go and now they're all selected. I can grab one of them and they'll all move at the same time. They'll all move together, and I slide it over into that Audacity folder and I drop it. As you can see now, they're all copying over. Now, and this may take a second or two. Now, once they're copied over, we can close these folders. We don't need these open anymore, so we can close both these. So now we're going to try to export an MP3 file. And I'll go to File, Export, and it'll ask me to name the file, so you can call it whatever you like. And click Save. Now, the next thing it's going to do is it's going to ask us to find to locate the lame file that we need, okay? So we're going to click Yes here. We only have to do this once. So, you know, just step through this with patience, and we only have to do this one time. Now, we're going to go to My Computer. Okay, so double-click on My Computer. Next, double-click on the C drive again, local disk C, mine is called. Yours may be called something different, but it's the C drive. Okay, make sure it's marked C. Double-click on that one. Next, we're going to double-click on Program Files. Okay, that's Program Files, so find that folder there in your list and double-click on that one. And then the last we're going to need is Audacity. So double-click on the Audacity file folder. And then, look, here's the file we need, the lame file. And you can click on that one, that lame underscore enc.dll, and then click OK. Now, that's it. We've done it. So now we can export MP3s as often as we like. Now, what you see here in front of you is for putting in tags on your MP3s. You know, you can give it a title, and you can say the, you know, whoever it was that played the music and the album that it's on or whatever. And that shows up on MP3 players when they're playing that music. But you don't have to do that if you don't want to. Now, once we've got the MP3 encoder, the lame encoder, set up in Audacity, we never have to do that again. So you don't have to memorize what we just did or really completely understand what we just did. Just go through the steps that I outlined, and you'll never have to do it again. So that's it, just a one-time deal. So that's it. Now you can export MP3s as often as you like. Now it's also worth mentioning as well that MP3 files are very, very small. I said in another tutorial that you could also export as WAV. Now WAV files are very, very large. You may have a WAV file that's maybe 3 minutes long, might be 40 megs, which is a very large file. Whereas the same file as an MP3 might only be two megs. If you're sending something over the internet, you really want to use MP3. It's a lot smaller. The sound quality is not as good as WAV, but the file size is quite a bit smaller. So something for you to consider as you're sending your music around.